God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and I will take you to myself, that where I am, there you may also be.
Please be seated. People departed, the sure benefits of your Son's saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last days, when you gather up all things in Christ, you may then enjoy the fullness of your promise through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen. Creator God, we gather today to stand in honor of our comrade. We stand with family and friends, and we ask you to make this place holy, a place set apart to honor and remember Canadians who have served their country in the ultimate sacrifice. Loving God, a savior, a soldier knows that the most important people in the battle are those on the left and the right. And we give you thanks for those people on our left and on our right. Private Albert Lubinstein has stood for us, and now we stand for him. May you comfort and strengthen and guide us in all that we're called to do. Chaplains aren't responsible for the weather, really. So if you're looking to me for praying, I didn't get that order for prayer for good weather, but we're going to muscle through here. At the top of your program is the 23rd Psalm. I invite you to read this aloud with me. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not be in want. He makes me lie down in green pastures and leads me beside the still waters. He revives my soul and guides me along the right pathway for his name's sake. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You spread a table before me in the presence of those who trouble me. You have anointed my head with oil, and my cup is running over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. The Lord be with you. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. This is the scripture reading where Jesus comforts his disciples. And Jesus says, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. And when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again, and take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. And Thomas said to Jesus, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How will we find the way? And Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. The Gospel of Christ. Let us pray. God, in all consolation, in your unending love and mercy, you turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life. Show compassion to your people who have been affected by war. Be our refuge and our strength to lift us from the bondage of terrorism and strife to the peace and light of your presence. Your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by dying for us, conquered death, and by raising again, restored life. Loving God, we gather here today to honor the sacrifice of a Canadian who has answered the call to serve his country. In this time of remembrance, let us be assured that of God's presence in our midst, and ask him to comfort and guide us. On the top of the following page is the Lord's Prayer. Please pray this prayer with me. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We now have the commendation of this service. Give rest, O Christ, to your servants with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of all, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth we shall return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust. Yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia. Give rest, O Christ, to your servants with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Albert. Acknowledge, we pray, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive him into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen.
Amen.
The act of remembrance. They shall grow not old, as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun, and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you.
closing benediction. God, our Creator, we commend into your hands our brother. In this life, he answered the call to serve his country and laid down his life in the cause of freedom. May all that was good in this man's life not be lost, but will be of a benefit to the world, that all that was important to him will be respected by those who follow. We ask for your presence to be with all who are affected by the tragedies of war, to strengthen all who suffer, and that we find peace in our hearts and treasure the freedom secured by the sacrifice of others. We pray that we may uphold the torch entrusted to us so that their sacrifice may not have been in vain. Give us the strength and courage in the days ahead to continue to serve our nation. Albert, Private Albert Rubinstein, at the going down of the sun and in the morning, we shall remember you. Amen. that's the ceremony. People are invited to come up and pay their respects to at the gravesite if they wish.
God bless.